that.
Be blessed. God bless. We're on Facebook, so I know a few of you already out there on it. Y'all already connected. Let us get connected, and we're going to catch up with you.
Hello, hello.
Y'all way ahead of us. God bless.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening.
Good evening. God bless. God bless.
Yes, we have someone. I just got it. Swipe them in.
God bless.
Hi, folks.
I'm going to help me get in there. Jean Rodney. Nikita Brown. God bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Rose and George. Emma Jean Rodney. Joyce Benjamin.
Hello. Good evening. Good evening to you all. Good evening.
Hello. God bless you. Sister Wanda August. Hello. The Angel of Faith. KKAY, the fair city of Donaldsonville.
Yes, yes.
God bless you, Sister Trina Condo.
Hi, Trina.
Condo Butler, I'm sorry. Chantel Warren, God bless you. Israel, brother no.
Hi, Gwen. Good evening.
Sister Briscoe is in tonight.
Yes, Briscoe, babe.
Bristol. I'm sorry. Praise the Lord.
Good evening.
Sister Walker, God bless you. Bless you.
Hello, Sister Parker.
Chante William DiOrio. See you, Brother Leo Brooks is in the house.
Hi, Brother Leo.
God bless you. Maxine from Leeds City, Texas.
Hi, Sis Maxine.
Reverend Raymond Collins. My favorite daughter. Chelsea Emily Brown.
Hi, Chelsea.
CB.
Yeah. Y'all come on in. Take a seat. Grab your refreshments.
God bless you, Sister Janice
Deason.
Prep Wartman.
Hi, Sister Janice.
Stella Jones, God bless you.
Hello, hello, hello. Good
Sister
evening.
Jocelyn Dunn.
Hi, Sister Jocelyn. Sister Bristol.
Amen. She said, I ain't got to apologize. Thank you, Sister Sister Bristol. I should know it by now, though.
He's bad with names.
Camlin Vernon, God bless you.
Hi, Cammy.
She only
taking
did
a break
earlier.
From studying.
Leslie Nicola, pray God that you're all is well with you.
Hi, Sister Leslie.
Sister Yolanda Wilson, God bless you.
Yes. Is Yolanda on tonight?
Yes. Yeah.
Hello,
yeah.
Yolanda.
God bless Sister Juanita Raymond. Hey, Cayman.
Hi, Collins.
All right, my our
yeah,
new
come on in. This is our virtual opening.
Sister
we
Melissa
get
Hudson, God bless you. Certainly praying with
good
you
evening,
and for
Sis
you.
Melissa, yes, we're continually holding you, covering you in prayer, and your family.
I found out something last night, Renee, that Melissa is my cousin.
It's all in the family.
In
huh?
The family. The Rayborns, Daryl and Michelle, Rayborn
hello,
families.
Hello. Rayborn.
Jared and Jordan.
Yes.
Kamika, God bless you. Marianne Winchester. Certainly praying
good
with
evening,
you and
good evening to you all. Come on in. Let's see. We have some Zoom
sister-in-law
participants joining in
Shalita.
As well. Hi, Mother. I see you're in.
I see your root.
Sis Cliff.
My manager.
Sis Connie, Brother Cliff. Some of the numbers I don't recognize, so please excuse me if I'm not calling you by name, but welcome you all.
I see mother-in-law is in the house
yes, she
on
is
Zoom.
There.
God
she
bless you, mother-in-law.
She has logged in. She has a seat at the table.
Sister Alexis, Audrey Alexis, God bless you.
We are going to be dealing with belonging.
A place to belong. Hallelujah.
our music selections are dealing with just needing each other, belonging to each other. So we want y'all to let it marinate.
Good evening, Sister Sandra Carlos William.
The bling bling lady.
The bling bling. I might have to do my Christmas in what? This September coming up, huh? Go sneak down there and get them diamonds for you. Matter of fact, we got an anniversary coming up. 28 years. I'm gonna have to hook you up, girl. Get the hook up.
Really?
Sound like I might have to call you.
Hi, sis. Shalita, taking a break. Are you on the patio?
Okay, I see the evangelist walking in. Tolaire.
Come bless on you. In.
Sister Kathy Brunch.
Hi, Kathy. We hope you all have been, taking it easy. We're thanking God for being spared yet again from what could have been. But of course, our prayers go out to our neighboring counties and neighbors in Louisiana, southwest, northwest Louisiana, as they're,
And we certainly
taking stock of the damages and how to recover and clean up and move forward. So
in the morning, sure they're going to find places to pick up where we can send some sort of support or help, and we're going to be doing something and sending some sort of relief from the church. So
hi, Tamara and Tamika, welcome. Good evening. We're going to be getting started in a few.
Sister Connie in the back. Well, Sister Connie is a reflex. She said, okay, whatever going to stay up.
she has insurance.
Yeah, right. She got a generator. She got a backup plan.
Backup plan.
The power wall here. I know where I can skip over.
Wi-Fi. You know, with this technology, you don't really know from time to time, use to use, what may happen, what may not happen. So we're grateful yet for your patience.
Certainly.
And your due diligence to just hang in there with us as we may experience technical difficulties here and there. I need you to survive.
Come on, let's go. We do it.
When you just reflect on that song and let the lyrics really resonate, it's really poignant, even in these lessons that we've been having.
That's what the church
is about. Purpose-driven life,
family.
And just what God, how he has rolled out to us, the love that we really should be about exhibiting. That's what he requires of us. And if there's ever a time we really need to reflect love, it is during these times of unrest and injustice. I mean, you can get so caught up on, especially with social media, just seeing the hatred and just feeling, just in this country, in our country. It's been, generations upon generations, but it just seems to have been magnified on so many levels in this day and age. And as Christians, we don't want to get caught up. We still, even in the midst of it all, we still want to be able to let our light shine so that men will see our good works and glorify the Father in heaven. So just always keep that in mind, even when we are being tried and tested and tempted to maybe go there, be reminded of who we represent we're ambassadors.
God bless you, Jimmy Joseph.
Hi, Jimmy.
I wanted to say hi to Shauna Moore, my cousin, is on.
Hi,
from California. God bless you. Sister Smith, the first name, and then you might want to help me with that one.
Ashanti.
I don't want to mess nobody's name up.
Good evening, Ashanti Smith. Welcome.
Love you, my brother. In. God bless you. We're proud of you, Jimmy. God bless you, man.
Yes, Sis Rose, we have to continue speaking peace. Amen. And that's what we represent as Christians.
I see T. Liz in the house. Liz.
Hi, T. Liz.
God bless you. Pray Slim and all the families
doing
well.
And Uncle Slim, if he's nearby and watching as well.
Brother Harold Taylor from Lafayette. God bless you. Pray all is well. You're safe. And of course, storm was a little close to y'all, and I know
yeah,
that.
And so they were dealing with the rioting as well as the unrest that's taking place area as well, you know. Hi, Sissy Melda Jones. You're watching us.
Sister
we
Jones,
love you and blessing
you.
All
right. Sister Peter, Sister Love, Peter Brown.
Hi, Peter.
She's on the Zoom
She's on
network.
Zoom, huh?
I need you to
We need each other. And so just keep that in mind.
God bless you, Stella.
When we be tried and tempted and possibly drugged into just mayhem that just really doesn't make sense.
Sister Albertina Dorsey, Sister Neighbor. God bless you, Sister Neighbor.
Hi, Sister Neighbor. Brother Larry.
Reverend August, God bless you.
Good evening, good evening.
God bless you.
We're just going to play that a little snippet of it again, and then we're going to get started.
We're going to really, really hammer on the church. The body of Christ, the Amen. Family of God, and the importance of us as members, how we not only believe, but belong and being connected, and why it's so important and imperative that, especially during this time where we are so disconnected, where we really need to make sure that we are connected, because God did not design us to be alone, even in a perfect garden. God said it's not good. So we really want to get to the place and, of course, dealing with accountability about showing that love and helping and supporting and encouraging one another.
Good evening to those additional individuals who are joining us on Zoom, not recognizing the numbers.
That's my Walmart co-worker. Y'all fired me and hired my son.
A mess.
Y'all hired my son and took my son in.
Everybody look at somebody and tell them, I need you.
So we want that to resonate before we get started, because we're going to be
touching
upon belonging.
I need you to agree with me.
We're all a part of God's body.
Well, I'm thinking I'm almost ready for solo.
And
girl,
in keeping that in mind, just as I said, just let that marinate that we need each other. We need each other to survive. And of course, that's the great Hezekiah Walker. When he came out with that song, it was so poignant and it was so heartfelt, and it resonated across the nation. And if there's ever a time we need to allow to let that song resonate, it is in these times that we're going through, that we're dealing with such social unrest, injustice, and just all the havoc and everything that is just being on display. We have to remember as Christians how we are to represent and where we choose we stand in. And God is watching. And so it is so easy for us to kind of get caught up in the mayhem, especially if you're on social media, to get caught up in the naysaying and everything that's being spewed. I mean, from the very top. And we're not going to go into calling words or anything. We really just need to be prayerful and in prayer. Not get dragged into the rabbit hole and the cat nips of social media or any other type of media. but to know who we are in Christ and to let that really reflect in our lives. So good evening to each and every one of you all. We're again so grateful, so humble that you all take time, set aside time, make room to really just be in tune with us, to fellowship with us on a weekly basis. As you know, this is our Bible study condensed to in half an hour, and we call it table talk. But diving into, of course, purpose-driven life, really being reminded of our purpose, that we are purposefully living. We are purposely here, and God desires us to live in purpose, to live in His purpose. And we are hoping that you all have allowed these lessons to really resonate, to really be an awakening, to be insightful, to be something that you can really just use to mature. We all haven't arrived yet, so and we're always striving for perfection, always striving to mature and develop and to grow. So of course, this segment is partly with us spreading the love of God. And of course, at Emmaus, we hold true to a mission of spreading love. That is, we love the Lord, we love each other, and we love the lost. We are growing and flowing in love. And we are a church that is Christ-centered, Bible-based, and family-focused. And we hope that you're feeling it, that you're receiving it. And we welcome any new person that's joining in with us on tonight. So before we get started, we're going to open up coming from Romans, the 12th chapter. Romans, the 12th chapter. You want to grab your Bibles, your devices, or you just want to give an ear to the reading of the scripture. Again, that's Romans, the 12th chapter. I'm going to read verses 1 through 5. And it reads, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. For I say, through the grace of given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God had dealt to every man the measure of faith. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office. Verse 5. So we, being many, are one body in Christ, and every one members one of another. I've just read Romans, the 12th chapter, verses 1 through 5. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of His holy word. And again, on tonight, we're going to pick up with, as we've been journeying in a purpose-driven life, we're going to pick up with the theme, a place to belong, a place to belong. But before we dive in, we're going to have the pastor to open up with prayer.
Let us pray. Father in heaven, we come today in the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes,
come with humble and repentant heart. Come, Father God, realizing that you, Lord of Lords, and kings above all kings. And God, you are absolutely worthy of all praise, all glory, and honor. And God, we come on tonight to give you glory, Lord God. We come, dear God, to give you an offering, dear God, a sacrifice of praise. That is, with the fruits of our lips, we give thanks to your name. God, we thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for your love, your mercy, and grace. Thank you for being such a faithful God. And God, we thank you, dear God, for the blessed privilege, dear God, you afford us, dear God, to come, dear God, into this time to break bread with our fellow members, Lord God. Thank you for giving us the technology. And innovative and creative way, Lord God, that we can stay connected, Lord God. And so, Father God, as we come today, Lord God, we do recognize and acknowledge that we can't do absolutely nothing apart from you, Lord God, but we can do all things through Christ who gives us the strength. So, Father, we decrease. We ask that you would increase. God, speak to us and speak through us. Lord God, let the very words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, because you are my strength and my redeemer, my Savior and Lord. To these and all blessings we ask in Jesus' name, and for our sake we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen. Praise the
a
Lord.
A place to belong.
A place to belong. Of course, we, again, Sister Brown, we're dealing with a purpose-driven life. And the reason why I teach this and I've taught it on two occasions, as you've always mentioned, and the third occasion, because it's so important, it's imperative that we understand that we need to understand purpose.
Yes.
Because everything God created it with purpose.
With purpose.
And purpose really give meaning to life. Mm-hmm. When I don't know my purpose, I really I don't know meaning to life, and so I really don't have life. Mm-hmm. Of course, whenever purpose is not known, abuse, misuse, and abnormal use. And so we talked about we were created for the glory of God, mm-hmm. and now from the glory of God, we're created, we're formed to be in the family of God. Yes. And of course, on yesterday, last week, we talked about what matters most, mm-hmm. of course, love. Mm-hmm. Love never fails. And we talked about that, expressing that love through time, and when the best time to do it is now. Mm-hmm. Of course, now being part of the family of God is being a part of the body of Christ, mm-hmm. which is the church, a place to belong.
Yes.
And it's so important as we deal with the place of belong tonight, because with COVID-19, so many things are happening in so many different levels. It affecting us in so many ways, mm-hmm. especially as it relates to the church, the body of Christ. Yes. The church have really been impacted and affected in so many ways where that disconnection has gone in. And when you have disconnection in the body of Christ,
yes.
because we belong to it, and we're going to be explaining to you, we belong to it, is almost taking a fish out of the water, mm-hmm. and a fish can't survive. It's almost taking a child from a parent, mm-hmm. and telling that child to go by himself. Mm-hmm. It's taking a organ, mm-hmm. out of your body, mm-hmm. and there's no way your body cannot. Mm-hmm. Of course, and because we are sheep, we need to flock together.
Yes.
And so tonight we're going to talk about this place to belong and why it's so important and imperative, mm-hmm. that we need to connect. So, Sister Brown, you go on the paper, please.
Okay, well, taken from the paper. You are called to belong, not just believe.
Mm-hmm.
Even in the perfect, sinless environment of Eden, God said, it is not good for man to be alone.
Mm-hmm.
We are created for community, fashioned for fellowship, and formed for a family. And none of us can fulfill God's purposes by ourselves.
So I want to just stop and elaborate on that a little bit. Mm-hmm. Of course, we were created again to be in fellowship.
Mm-hmm.
We were created not just to believe God, mm-hmm. because a lot of us believe God, mm-hmm. but we also belong into the body of Christ. And when they talk about the perfect environment that Adam was in, mm-hmm. everything God said, it was good. But then everything had two of his kind, mm-hmm. but for Adam, it didn't. Mm-hmm. And so God come back and say, in the perfect environment, mm-hmm. you know, he say, it's not good. And what he say, it's not good, mm-hmm. to be alone. Mm-hmm. And of course, there was no one like Adam. Of course, you know the story. Adam went to sleep. God gave him and present him a wife. Mm-hmm. Now, as a believer in Christ, we don't need to get married.
Mm-hmm.
We just need to, you know, if you're lonely and you're feeling isolated, you just need to find your place, connect in the church, and be a part of the family of God. And this is this is the purpose of the church, because the church is God's family, mm-hmm. on earth.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to make sure we throw that in there, Sister Brown. So please don't go get married. Join
just
the church.
Because you're lonely.
If you're lonely, find your church, a family.
The Bible knows nothing of solitary saints. Or spiritual hermits,
mm-hmm.
isolated from other believers or deprived of fellowship. The Bible says we are put together, joined together, built together, members together, heirs together, fitted together, and held together, and will be caught up together. You're not on your own anymore.
Praise the Lord. So once I become a believer in Christ, once I become a believer, I belong to the body of Christ, in order for me to fulfill that particular purpose, then I need to be part of the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you see the Bible talks about together, built together,
mm-hmm.
we held together.
Mm-hmm.
One day we're going to be caught up together.
Together.
It talks about praying one for another. So all of this is together. Mm-hmm. And what the enemy wants to do, and I'm telling you, the enemy comes in and he calls schism to come within the church, because he already know, if I can divide you,
mm-hmm.
I can weaken you.
Mm-hmm.
If I can divide you, mm-hmm. I can conquer you.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things as a pastor, pastor is what I pride myself on is that we all together in unity. There's no big to whom much is given, much is required.
Right.
And so I'm gonna do more because God, where God has placed us. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna make everyone feel that they are part of this body of Christ. So there's no big person or a division here and there. Because if it's a division, mm-hmm. then it's my duty and responsibility to address it. Mm-hmm. Because I know how the enemy works. Mm-hmm.
And it speaks to, you know, God does things decent and in order. And of course, when we as Christians are just, we as individuals, make it our business, make it our purpose to really be in alignment with God's will, we mm-hmm. know that's when things are fine. But chaos come when division is brought about. Mm-hmm. And of course, we know we're dealing with a lot of chaoticness that's going on in this world
Great.
Now because of the divisiveness that is taking
place. Division, correct.
And of course, all of that is against the will of God. So when we're going against the will of God, that's when we know chaos is going on.
And that's why I tell people, a lot of times people come with stuff. Mm-hmm. I tell people, check a person's heart, because one of the things you got to always know that a person who deals with a beam in their own eye, it's hard for them to deal with a mote in the brother eye. And
right.
God always being a God of order, mm-hmm. you know, we have to deal with our own self before we start dealing. So when people come, we have to learn how to shut down mm-hmm. stuff. Because, and I tell my son all the time, listen, when you're dealing at work, a lot of people are crying and complaining. You run away from that. You don't want that kind of stuff mm-hmm. to get in your spirit, because the enemy is constantly at work to try to bring
division,
to tear down, mm-hmm. to conquer, mm-hmm. Divide and conquer. Mm-hmm. Go to the next one.
While your relationship to Christ is personal,
mm-hmm.
God never intends it to be private.
Praise the Lord.
In God's family, you are connected every other believer, and we will belong to each other for eternity.
Praise the Lord. So, of course, my relationship might be personal, but it's not a private. It's no such thing as a private Christian. When folks are just constantly back, and you know, when people are at home, mm-hmm. especially with the COVID-19, it is my duty to innovatively find ways to still connect mm-hmm. with our elders, connect with, but there are some individual that you don't hear from. Mm-hmm. It's because they're not connected. Mm-hmm. They're not connected. And so God want us to be committed to each other, and not every one of us. We're committed and connected to each other, and we all, as a song would say, we need each other.
Amen. And as Christians, when we have yielded ourselves, have given ourselves to Christ, that's something that you can't just hold to yourself. Because mm-hmm. you want to be, as Christians, we're supposed to be, spreading the good news. So in order to spread the good news, that means you're connecting to others to do that. You can't really just be live in isolation, as we just read, or mm-hmm. be a hermit about Christianity. Christianity is something that you want to share, that you're supposed to share, that God requires us to share. And of course, that ties into connecting
Praise
and being
Lord.
Belonging
I'm
with
not
others.
A private Christian. Mm-hmm. I'm
right.
a public
mm-hmm.
Christian.
It's a personal relationship. It's a personal experience.
But it is shown mm-hmm. public.
Right.
Praise the Lord. Even in my declaration of my faith through baptism, it's a public mm-hmm. Declaration that I am a follower of Christ. And so now, how I make that declaration, because I get baptized once, but I take communion twice. But I constantly make that declaration when I'm joined mm-hmm. with other brothers
with
and
other
sisters
brothers
in Christ.
Because we uplifting each other,
Amen.
We exalting each other. Following Christ includes belonging, not just believing.
Mm-hmm.
We are members of his body, which is the church.
Praise the Lord. Of course, keep going, Sister Brown.
The church is the body, not a building, an organism, not an organization.
Mm-hmm.
For the organs of your body to fulfill their purpose, they must be connected to your body.
Mm-hmm.
The same is true for you as a part of Christ's body. You were created for a specific role, but you will miss this second purpose of your life if you're not attached to a living local church.
Praise the Lord. If you're not attached to a living local church, a church that is preaching and teaching the word of God, mm-hmm. Now you're missing out on fulfilling this second purpose, mm-hmm. which is you created not just to believe, but you were created to belong. Mm-hmm. And you have a place in the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. And if you feel that even the place that you're in, if it's a place of isolation, mm-hmm. and you don't feel connected, where you're not functioning, mm-hmm. it's time to start praying and thinking about, you know, I need to find a place where I really can fulfill this second purpose. Because in order for me to have fulfillment and peace, is really doing what I was created to do. Mm-hmm. I love my wife. I really do. I love her. But nobody can do me like God in understanding what He created me for. Mm-hmm. And that's the joy. But Nehemiah said, "The joy of the Lord is my strength." Mm-hmm. For him to leave out of his comfort, mm-hmm. In the comfort of being a cupbearer right next mm-hmm. to the king, but yet he gets out and go and build up a community that has mm-hmm. been devastated, mm-hmm. Not because of Hurricane Laura, mm-hmm. but a different storm that was because of their own sin. But yet he would declare that the joy of the Lord is my strength, because he's doing what God had created him to do. And I tell people all the time, you know, joyful because I'm doing what I created to do. Mm-hmm. And what I was created to do, nobody can stop that. Nobody can take that away. Praise the Lord.
That's the joy in serving the Lord. And if you're doing it purposefully. Mm. We don't want to just sit there and going through the motion. You are active. When you're a Christian, you're supposed to be actively working out your soul salvation.
Working out that salvation. Praise
and
the Lord.
That is not your own. Connecting and working together as a family.
Well, we're going to show you that really you rob not only God, mm-hmm. but you're robbing the church. Mm-hmm. Not just a lot of time we talk about the tithes, mm-hmm. but we forget about to put emphasis on the time mm-hmm. and the talent.
And the talent.
Praise the Lord. Go to the next one.
Why we need a church family.
Okay, we're going to list six of these, and we're going to go in the text.
Number one, a church family identifies you as a genuine believer.
Praise the Lord. So I'm in the church, and I'm part of the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. And really, when I'm connected to the church, it really identifies me as a genuine believer. Remember, when I'm connected, the church is the body of Christ. Mm-hmm. And I want you to understand that. We are the bride of Christ. Mm-hmm. And God will really be upset with you if you love him, but you hate his bride.
Oh,
and so
on.
And so in John 14:35, say, a new commandment I give unto you, mm-hmm. that you love one another as I love you. Mm-hmm. Love one another. Now he says, I want you to love one another mm-hmm. the same way I love you. So when I'm dealing with a church, I got different personalities.
Yes.
I got different people. But guess what? God put these people in there so that you can do what?
Yes.
Love them.
Come on.
He said, by this the world will know that you are what? My disciple, you're following me based on you loving, you loving people unconditionally. And so I can tell you're a genuine mm-hmm. follower of Christ based on the fact that you're connected to the local church. You're connected to his bride. Go to the next one.
Number two, a church family moves you out of self-centered isolation.
Praise the Lord. It moves you. In the Psalm 133 say, behold how good
and pleasant.
It is for brethren to dwell together in unity. You read Hebrew chapter 10, verse 25. Mm-hmm. It says, seek not the self for the assembling of others, mm-hmm. but exalt one another mm-hmm. for so much as you see the day approaches. When you think about that, the day approaches, we are going to go through, life is a cycle, mm-hmm. and we're going to all go through a place where we're going to need somebody.
Yes.
And we're going to need to lean on somebody. Mm-hmm. And so when you're in a place of isolation, mm-hmm. when you're in that place, mm-hmm. then when you going through your trials and tribulation, mm-hmm. well, where you was when I was going through mm-hmm. it. You got to come out of the isolation. Mm-hmm. Anyone?
A church family helps you develop spiritual muscle.
Praise the Lord. So because we're gifted and talented and we got so many things that we're doing in church, so many ministry that we offer in church, and so we want to help you. It's my duty and responsibility as a pastor to help you see that gift, recognize that gift, mm-hmm. and help you develop that gift. Proverbs 27:17, write it down for just a habit to make sure iron sharpen iron. So a man, a woman sharpen the countenance of a friend. Yes. And that's what we ought to do. We ought to be able to sharpen each other, help each other, because all of that does mm-hmm. is help the body of Christ, mm-hmm. which is Christ's body, mm-hmm. which is his bride. become what you want, what God had ordained it to be on earth.
And it's not about being envious of each other. It's really about, you know, celebrating each other. We're all different. We all want to have different gifts. So celebrate that in each other and know that we're using it for
His
kingdom building.
All the glory. Mm-hmm. And like you always tell me, Sister Brown, and I get it. I understand it. I really do. You know,
stay in your lane.
Okay, we're going to move on. She tell me stay in my lane, and my wife will rebuke me in the midst of the service. She'll rebuke me, and I'm like, okay, I'm the pastor, what? But guess what? I stay in my lane.
Because it's not depriving you of just enjoying that fellowship across the spectrum. It's just a certain thing we all are gifted to be in the forefront of, if you will, in the forefront.
And praise the Lord. And you know, and I got to give myself credit. I don't rebel. I don't try to do. I just take it and gracefully move into my land. Sometimes I'm out and about, and I just get caught up, y'all. I'm singing song and calling the wrong words out. I'm throwing the choir
and
off,
so
when I go back and listen to it, I got to come home and listen. I came. I'm like, okay, I'm coming in the house. I know I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna get it.
I know Brother Craig gonna have something to say.
But praise the Lord. But we develop each other muscles. Yes, we're building each other up.
Yes.
All right.
Number four, the body of Christ needs you and you and you and you and you.
Praise the Lord. Uh-huh. Think about it. We need you.
Yes.
In order for this church. We talked about the body. We're going to go about the different parts. There are many members, but one body. All members have not the same office, but we all one. In my body, we have a different parts of my body, but all of my, I'm telling you, matter of fact, I broke my finger and broke that middle finger, and it's still messed up, but I had to go through surgery, and I'm telling you, everything hurt on me, everything, just that one finger, and so when we have an individual that are out of place and not connected, it robbing the body of Christ, the bride of Christ, of functioning as it ought to in the earth realm.
Number five, you will share in Christ's mission in the world.
Praise the Lord. Now here it is with COVID-19 and now with Hurricane Laura, and thank God we've in our area, we've seen tropical storm and little rain and little wind, but we didn't get much. But now it's time for the church really to be good neighbors.
Yes.
Sheriff and other agencies going out to Lake Charles and doing whatever they could to assess the damage and try to help out. But you know, they're going to have people drop off points and bring in clothes and different things. You know, make sure that we come to church, get together, pray, and see what we can do to help out. Because just like it's in Lake Charles, it can easily be happening. It could happen right here with us. And so coming to church, help us be about the mission. Of God on earth. And this is the last purpose we have. Mm-hmm. And it's the only thing that we can't do when we get to heaven. Mm-hmm. God has given us the commission to go into all the world. And you know what? What better time to fulfill that when we know our brother and sister are going through?
Yes. And number six, a church family will help keep you from backsliding.
Praise the Lord. Now, Sister Brown, I was reading an article, and through COVID-19, and it was very very alarming. They say 20% of the people that were in church going to backslide.
My Lord.
Out of church. Mm-hmm. Because listen, we've been out of church 24 weeks. Mm-hmm. And some people have been, you know, they were already fence traveling.
Yes.
You know, they were already, and so now, because the church, especially church trying to figure out how to get open back up, church closed, and so on and so forth, but being part of that church, the sheep are scattered, now so many people are backsliding. Mm-hmm. And listen, people, it's easy to backslide. Y'all remember 73 Psalm, I'm going to finish it up this week. ASAP was a minister of music. Mm-hmm. He's leading a choir, and he's doing great. He talked about how good God is, and surely God is good to Israel. Mm-hmm. But he said, but for me, I'm going to be honest with you. I almost slipped.
Yes.
I almost backslide.
Uh-huh.
And if it wouldn't have been for the sanctuary, if the church wouldn't open Sunday morning, I'd have just had to give up because he struggled watching the wicked prospering.
Yes.
He struggled watching how it looked like they weren't going through nothing. Mm-hmm. But he said, when I went to church, mm-hmm. the church will help us to keep us from backsliding.
Yeah.
And I know, you know, I was one of those Christian, and not a Christian, but I used to go to church. I'm gonna be honest with you, during the holidays. And Sister Trina, I would go up doing, Christmas or something, and then the next year I'm going back up, and it was hard for me to keep going up there doing the same, you know. And I was shame. And there's a lot of people, you know, they make that vow. I'm going up this time. I'm gonna stay in. And I mean, you know, that's a vow you making.
Yes.
But you got to get to the place. You can't do that on your own. Mm-hmm. You got to allow Him to come into your life.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, once He comes in your life,
yes.
He's going to give you the power,
yes.
not only to be in church, but to stay
in church.
Stay connected.
Hallelujah.
Because the church keeps you from backsliding. Of course, we're in Romans chapter number 12.
Mm-hmm.
We're in Romans chapter number 12. I got to run this up quickly. Romans chapter number 12, Paul is writing this preparatory lesson. And of course, he hasn't visited Rome yet. He's writing this particular letter. He talks about the power of salvation, the message of the cross. And he's writing this letter. And whenever you read the book of Romans, it's basically a miniature Bible. He starts off in chapter 1, 2, and 3. Talks about sin. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. He talks about the universal need of receiving the salvation of God. The salvation that God had provided for us through Christ Jesus, chapter 4 and 5. Chapter 6 through 8, after receiving the salvation through the conviction of the Holy Spirit and confessing Him as Lord, now the Spirit now takes residence in my life, and it's called sanctification. Mm-hmm. The sanctification is a process whereby I'm being conformed in the image of Christ. It's a progressive work that begins in the regeneration and carried out in the heart of a believer by the present power of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit is at work. That's why when he's talking about Romans 8:28, and this we know all things. God is working on me.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, and from the salvation 9 through 11, he talks about God is sovereign.
Mm-hmm.
How many of y'all know God is a God of order?
Oh, yes.
You can't get to Romans chapter 12 mm-hmm. until you deal with Romans chapter 1, 2, and 3.
You can't
get to Romans chapter 12 until you accept the salvation Christ's order. You can't get to Romans chapter 12
mm-hmm.
until you allow the Spirit of God to do a work in you
yes.
and that you're allowing God now mm-hmm. to be in control.
Mm-hmm.
And when Paul comes up in chapter 12, Paul said, now therefore,
uh-huh.
he's talking about therefore because of all of those particular reason. I beseech you, I'm praying mm-hmm. for you, therefore, by the mercy of God, this is the inspiration that you present your body as a living sacrifice. So now he's talking about, listen, we talk about our commitment to each other, but really he's talking about our service
mm-hmm.
unto God. He said, I want you to give a living sacrifice,
yes. mm-hmm.
holy and acceptable unto God. I want you to be separated
yes.
and accelerated through God.
Mm-hmm.
And then verse number 2, he comes in, be not conformed
mm-hmm.
to this world. He's talking about the character of God,
mm-hmm.
but be transformed by what?
Renewing.
And so now my mind has to be removed,
mm-hmm.
but how my mind is renewed? By the word of God.
Yes.
We're going through a place of metamorphosis. When I'm coming to God, there ought to be some growth.
Yes.
You know, we can't continue to stay the same.
Mm-hmm.
And then he goes
Amen.
And check verse number
Amen.
3. I'm doing
Amen.
It quickly. Y'all need to come to, y'all need to get verse number 3. He moved from the character of
yes.
God to the condescending.
Mm-hmm.
He says in verse number 3, verse number 3, for I say through the grace given
mm-hmm.
to you, not to think of yourself more highly as you ought to.
My Lord.
But to think soberly. Because
mm-hmm.
so often we get to, go ahead, Sister Brown, you're already there. We get to the place where
Stay
we
humble.
Think it's all about
yes.
us. We think that we, you
yes.
know, and we have to stay humble.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about you, but humbleness keep me hungry.
Yes.
Humbleness. See, and it's a reason why they called me hum when I went up. It wasn't just because I didn't wear deodorant, y'all. I didn't wear deodorant. That's the truth. And I used to stay. I couldn't hum, but a song. But that was my nickname, Humdinger.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, now when I get saved, God remind me, you're not Humdinger no more. Just stay humble.
Yes, that's it.
Don't think you're know more than anybody else. And every time I think about the goodness of God and all that God,
when
I
think, you know.
I'm very confident. But when I think about where He bought me from, you know, how He picked me up, and listen, it's a blessing.
Yes.
And then now He talks about the capabilities in verse 4 and 5. Mm-hmm. I'm finished. I can't do no more because we almost finished. Verse 4 and 5. He talks about for we have many members in one body. All members have not the same office. Now He's talking about our differences. Mm-hmm. All of us are different.
Yes.
And we all have a gift. We don't have the same office. Mm-hmm. He says, so we being many, same thing. He talked about it. He paralleled that to the physical body. We being many are one body in Christ. Everyone member one of another. Christ had brought us into the pride of Christ and give us a diversity of gift. Mm-hmm. And our diversity of gift, our differences, it ought to not weaken us, but the diversity of the gift ought to strengthen us. Mm-hmm. And so I want to say to you that the church, the family of God, is a place to belong. Mm-hmm. If you're not connected, please,
please
get to connected. Mm-hmm. Because a child cannot make it without a family. An organ cannot make it without a body. Mm-hmm. And a sheep cannot make it without the flock. Mm-hmm. God bless you on tonight. I pray that this word has blessed you, and that God continue to keep you.
Amen, amen. Yet another powerful word. And again, we can't say it enough. It is about us in this together. We need each other, but we need each other purposefully for God's purpose. Not for no slick motive or any, what we can get out of it, but it is for kingdom building. It is for renewing each other and working to build God's kingdom. And we can't do it apart from God. We can't do it in isolation. Mm-hmm. When we learn, when we grow, when we develop, we wanna share that. We want to connect with somebody to really just form that
Hallelujah.
That unity that God really expects of us. It's about unity. It's about love. It's about serving God together. We're united, focused on what God requires of us, and that is building His kingdom. That is really being like lock-footed in the will of God. So again, belonging to each other, another yet powerful, powerful message and lesson that we hope have resonated with you all.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you. Let us continue to be prayerful for those and who have been.
Yes. Our sisters and brothers and neighboring communities.
Those who have died. I think about four lives earlier that I've seen, and of course those who may have lost property, and of course, and those who are away from their home don't know actually what is going on, and we pray for restoration and all.
Just the unrest and even, you know, in the wake of the natural disasters and things like that, the COVID situation, the unrest, and just, it's just so much that ties in with just us really be about letting our light shine and showing the love of Christ.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And I tell people all the time, if they don't see God in us while folks are going through it, if they don't see God in us, then they're not going to ever see God. This is a great opportunity for the church to fulfill its mandate, the mission and commission. So let us come together, pray, amen, and be about our Father's business. Heavenly Father, we come tonight in the name of Jesus. We come, Lord God, thanking you again for once again another place and time where we can come and to just be in your word, Lord God. Thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit, Lord God, the teacher who God, who teaches us all things, Lord God. We thank you for everyone that who have been a part of this fellowship on tonight. God, I pray that your word have had its free course, Lord God, that every heart, dear God, was able to receive, and every heart, every ear was attentive, and God, that word, Lord God, will truly, Lord God, come a living seed, Lord God, that it will produce a harvest 30, 60, 100-fold. We pray, Father God, for everyone on tonight, Lord God, every family. Lord God, we plead the precious blood over every family. Cover us, Lord God. And we thank you today, Lord God, that even what could have been, Lord God, and what should have been, Lord God, you protected us, Lord God. Not because, dear God, that we were praying for, not because, but because of your amazing grace, Lord God. And we want to thank you today, Lord God. But now, God, you told us that we were strong. We must bear the infirmity of those that are weak. You said that when we bear one another's burden, we are fulfilling the law of God. So God, even now, God, that if you bless us, Lord God, I pray, God, that we will find it in our heart, Lord God, to pay it forward, Lord God. I pray that we will find it in our heart, Lord God, to be able to reach out, dear God, to those who are hurting, those who are going through this difficult season tonight, Lord God. God, I pray for those who are going away from their home, who are concerned, dear God, about what they will find when they go back, Lord God. But God, we know that you, God, is able to give, Lord God, them even better, Lord God, that you are a restorer, Lord God. So God, I pray that even as they pick up the pieces, Lord God, that you would just give them peace of mind, Lord God. Give them, God, remove the anxiety, the worry, Lord God. Move it away from them, God. We come up against that enemy, Lord God. And God, give them a peace, Lord God. Let them know, Father God, everything that they have, Lord God, it come from you. And God, that you'll stay able to give them even more, dear God. Just as you give Job double for his trouble. God, we pray for those who have lost loved ones doing this, Lord God. We know, we ask that you will comfort these families. Comfort them with the comfort of the Holy Spirit. We pray, Father God, just for those who are mourning all over. And God, we pray for the sick, the shut-in, everywhere, Lord God. Special prayer, Father God, for those who, the agents who have already, dear God, who have went out, Lord God, doing search and rescue, going out, Lord God, to help these communities build back up again, Lord God. We want to thank you for it, Lord God. Again, Lord God, thank you for all who have assembled with us today. Again, continue to bless our schools, our faculty, our staff, our administration, the janitor, the bus driver, but most of all, God bless our children. God, I know you have not given them the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. God, give them a sound mind that they continue in their educational endeavor. And Father, for this we give you glory. We give you praise and honor. In Jesus' name and for our sake we pray. Amen and thank God.
Amen, amen, amen.
I pray for you. You pray.
Y'all be blessed. Love you all.
God bless you. Love you with the love of God.
I need you to survive. I won't harm you with words from my mouth. I love
you all.
I need you.